Hi, it's Alan from Crashtest Security. In this video, I will tell you more about how to protect your web apps from SSL LUCKY13 vulnerabilities. So let's get started. Apart from patches, several mitigation techniques exist that will allow you to protect yourself from this type of attack. These mitigation techniques were put forward by Alfarten and Patterson, who made this vulnerability known. They include the following techniques. Adding random time delays to the CBC mode decryption process to frustrate statistical analysis is a possible countermeasure you can take. However, it is not particularly effective if implemented solely, since attackers can overcome it by simply increasing the number of samples. One of the most straightforward mitigation techniques you can apply is to switch from a block cipher to an RC4 stream cipher to avoid the need for plaintext padding altogether. This cannot be implemented under datagram transport layer security. Switching a stream cipher will entirely eliminate the possibility of attacks, as described above. RC4 cipherswitches are widely supported in TLS implementations and are also a successful strategy against beast attacks. However, RC4 has certain cryptographic weaknesses when used in TLS that must be accounted for. RC4, when used in TLS, contains single-byte biases, which are not discarded before the encryption. This allows for remote attacks to be conducted, such as the bar mitzvah attack. For this reason, switching to RC4 is also only a temporary fix for the LUCKY13 vulnerability. Switching from MEETL-SCBC to AED cipher suits, i.e. dedicated encryption algorithms, such as AES-GCM, is also possible for eliminating the possibility of a LUCKY13 attack. This does not rule out the possibility for errors during implementation, nor the potential for the use of side channels. Support for these cipher suits was added in TLS 1.2 client and server implementations. Modifying the CBC mode decryption procedure is the final mitigation strategy proposed by Alfarten and Patterson. Its intended purpose is to remove the timing side channel by ensuring a uniform processing time for all ciphertexts under this mode. In other words, the processing time must only be related to the size of the ciphertext and not to the plaintext. This is achieved by ensuring that the MAC processing amount does not differ regardless of what the underlying plaintext indicates as the message length. This approach requires great care and attention, and is likely to present a challenge. For this reason, the most viable long-term mitigation strategy for avoiding SSL LUCKY13 attacks is to avoid using TLS in CBC mode and implement the use of AED cipher suits. In addition to the previously mentioned countermeasures, you can prevent the LUCKY13 attack by using the following transport layer security configuration in Apache and Nginx. With Apache, the SSL TLS configuration is stored in etc. Apache 2 mods enabled seccomp. If you use Let's Encrypt, the configuration may reside in etc. Let's Encrypt options SSL Apache conf. To enable only ciphers with high encryption and recent protocols set. Then reload the Apache server configuration. For Nginx, update the configuration file, which is usually located at etc. Nginx, nginxconf etc. Nginx, cited enabled yoursite.com Ubuntu Debian, or etc. Nginx, conft nginxconf rhel centos. Add the following directive to the server section. Then restart the Nginx server. Note that this limits the cipher suites and protocol versions to recent SSL TLS versions, which might exclude users with older browsers. Try Crashtest Security today to discover how it integrates into your development stack for efficient, automated vulnerability scanning. The trial is free. Also, subscribe to the Crashtest Security channel to get more information about the most significant web security threats, their prevention, and how to use the Crashtest Security Suite. Thank you for watching, and see you in our next video.